السلام عليكم. إن شاء الله in this tutorial we will start solving questions related to chapter 9, the phase diagram. We'll have different videos for the different sections in the chapter. In this video, إن شاء الله, we will solve a question related to the solubility limit. The solubility limit for many alloy systems and at some specific temperatures, there is a maximum concentration of solute atoms that may dissolve in the solvent to form a solid solution. This is called a solubility limit. So the first thing, for any alloy, we must be given a specific temperature, because the solubility limit will depend on this temperature. Okay? So that is the first thing. In this question, we'll have a temperature which is at 500 degrees Celsius. And solubility limit represent the maximum concentration, and usually we يعني represent the concentration like the composition, we represent it as a composition C, and usually the most used one is the weight percentage to represent the composition as we saw in chapter 4. Okay, but concentration of what, or the composition of what, of solute atoms that may dissolve in the solvent to form a solid solution. So we have a solvent, المذيب, okay, يعني assume at the beginning it has 100 degree, 100 weight percentage for the composition. Then you started adding some solute atoms and you dissolve it on this solvent, okay, until what? You will keep adding and the solute will dissolve in the solvent, like when you add sugar in tea. You can add it, then you dissolve it, then you cannot see the sugar. But if you add too much sugar, you can see it. It will not dissolve in the solvent, in the water, or in the tea. Okay? So we need to determine this limit. This limit, we call it the solubility limit. The addition of solute in excess of this solubility limit result in the formation of another solid solution. Like at the beginning, if you add sugar, okay, and you have tea and you add sugar, okay, you cannot see the sugar inside the tea. But after a while, you will see the sugar, the particles or the sugar, you can see it by your eyes, okay? That means that there is a new compound or a solid solution. At the beginning, it was only tea, and the sugar is dissolved inside it, it is homogeneous, okay? But now we have two things. You can see the water, and also you can see the sugar. Here the same thing. You have in the phase diagram different solid solution or compound. Like you have liquid, you have alpha plus liquid, you have alpha alone, alpha plus beta, beta. If any one of them يعني change to another solid solution, okay, that means it passes through the solubility limit. Okay, there is existed a new compound or a new solid solution that is different in composition. Okay, so now we need to know different things. First, we need to know the temperature, and we said we have in this question it is 500 degrees Celsius. Okay, I know the specific temperature. I need to know what is the solute atoms and what is the solvent. Okay, in order to determine the solubility limit. Here in the question, in part A, he said Cu in Ag. That means that Cu will dissolve in Ag. So Cu is the solute, المذاب. Okay, and Ag is the solvent. Okay, so at the beginning we have 100% at weight percent for Ag. Okay, then we added Cu, the copper, until what? We will add the copper, then the solid solution will change. So where is 100% Ag? Here, this x-axis represents the composition of Ag. So here, 0 means 0 weight percentage of Ag, and here 100 means it is 100 weight percentage for Ag. And that means also that is for Cu, it is the opposite. يعني for Cu, that means if it is 0 weight percentage for Ag, that means it is 100% for CU. And here, if it is 100% for weight percentage for AG, that means it is zero weight percentage of CU. So if I assume that the solvent is the AG, because he said CU in AG, that means AG is a solvent and CU will dissolve in AG, then I will start from the 100% weight percentage for AG at 500 degrees Celsius. So 500 is this line. Okay. And at this point, I have 100% AG. Then I will start adding CU until what? I will know the solubility limit, until there is a change in the solid solution or the compound. So at the beginning, I was here, and at this region, I have beta solid solution, okay? Or I have this compound beta, this phase, okay? Then I become, after this, I pass this blue line. Now I will be at this temperature at 500 degrees Celsius. I will have new solid solution, which is alpha plus beta. That means that is the solubility limit, this line, or at this point exactly, at this point represents the solubility limit for 500 degrees Celsius. This point, the x-axis, or the component in the x-axis, or the value in the x-axis, represents this value for AG, which is approximately 98% AG or 2% CU. So this composition or this concentration is the solubility limit, okay? So the solubility limit for part A is 98% for AG when the AG is 98 weight percentage, and 2% for the cover, okay? For part B, it is the opposite. We have AG in CU. That means this one, for example, that is part A. For part B, AG now is the solute. So AG is the solute, and CU is the solvent. So I will start from 100 weight percent for CU. That is corresponding to 0% for AG. So I will start from the left. Okay, so then I will start adding some AG until the solid solution change or the phase change. Now this region is alpha. Okay, if I pass this line, this blue line, I will have alpha plus beta. Okay, that means that this line represents the solubility limit. Okay, and for specifically at temperature 500 degrees Celsius, it is this point. Okay, this point corresponds to a value in the x-axis, which approximately the solution manual said it is 1.5 weight percentage for CU or 98.5 weight percentage for AG. So that is for the solubility limit. You must be given a temperature, and you need to know what is the solute and what is the solvent. Then you see the phase diagram and where the phase change, or there is a new compound existed or shown after you move in the horizontal direction in the phase diagram, then that is the point where the solubility limit exists. Then you can take the concentration or the composition from the x-axis by going down. So that is it for the solubility limit. Inshallah, next videos we will see in different sections related to chapter 9.